I love him. I know you all love him, and the animals love him for everything that he does. Please welcome Abby Gill.
Hi, everybody. I know there's nothing much that I can really bring here to the crowd as far as telling you to be vegan. But let me tell you about opportunities that we have, each one of us, and how we can actually help the animals. And what it is that I do is, for example, the other day I went to buy a van, and I looked at the eyes of the salesperson and said, he's my next victim. And why was he, in my eyes, kind of like the next victim to turn him into a vegan or a vegetarian? Because I saw some softness in his eyes. I say, can I not insult that person and see what it is that I can do in order to convince him to consume less animals? So the first thing that I do, and I think each one of us can do, is ask the people that we see if they love animals. And what it is that they always say, yes, we do. Because everybody loves animals, but they don't realize that they only like the cats, the dogs, the dolphins, the elephants, whatever, and then they have two lists. And then the next question I ask these people is, do you eat animals? And then they pause. And they think, I say, I'm not trying to insult you, I'm not judgmental, and I understand 7.7 billion people probably do, and you can be one of them, but do you? And then the person says, yeah, unfortunately I do, but I kind of like start cutting down. And I said to them, that's great that you do, because you know, people eat about 80 animals a year. Now, saving animals is very difficult. So if I can take my new victim, let's call him, and turn that person into a vegan or vegetarian, I can save 80 animals a year. If that person is 20 years old and would live another 60 years, and I just turn him into a vegan, I saved about 5,000 animals just by that one person. I save animals. I save monkeys, 1,250 in Israel. I have a shelter. It takes a lot of effort to save animals. But to take them off the plate of the people, and you come across these people every day in the supermarket, in the movie theater, every day. Just try to see, without insulting these people, can I get through to that person, and can I have a 5-minute conversation without offending them? And can they go home later and say, wow, this guy is right. I do have two lists. I have the list of the animal that I love, and I have the list of the animal that I eat. And these two cannot coexist because I really don't love animals. Then they start thinking and say, what did the cow do to me that I have to put that cow into suffering, not personally, but I paid somebody to kill that cow? And that is the awareness that we can bring into people without hurting them. All of us here probably understand that being vegan is good for the earth, it is good for us, it's good for everything. But really, those animals that have right to live here should have us as the little ambassadors going around and find these people. And these people, you won't believe, more than you can imagine, are willing to listen and to change. One of the things that I do is with Farm, we have the program of pay $1 to watch the video and go to university and do that. But I also do it on my personal level. So if you guys have 5 minutes, when you find somebody that you can talk to, and that person would listen to you, and there's a chance that you would turn that person into a vegan, 80 animals a year, 5,000 for their life, and whatever. Even if they do it for 2 years and they come back, you still save more animals than I can possibly save by buying them or by doing other activities. It is something so simple to do. Just try it. Don't offend the people, because once you have an attitude, they would not listen to you. But if you don't have an attitude, they would, and they would be more to come and talk to you, and probably they would think about what my next meal is going to be. So try to do this thing. I think it's going to do a lot for this world. Thank you so much.
Abby Gill, everyone. And leave it to Adi to make it like really practical about how we're going to save animals. That's why he's been so successful.